Hello friends, so welcome to my channel on the Rest Assured. So so hope you have gone through all the previous videos, right, where we have covered the basics of Rest Assured from basic to middle kind of level. We have already covered in the previous Rest Assured channel topics. Now what I'm planning, so now we are starting to go for some advanced topic, right, like some how to handle the SSL, TLS, etc. kind of things, okay, and how to do the serialization, deserializations using the Rest Assured. All those topic will be covered in the upcoming videos. Okay, so let's start with this SSL. So I hope you everyone of you know about the TLS SSL certificates, right? You must have seen that on the top part of the browser, some pop-up comes that the site is not secure, the site is secure kind of thing, right? So what are those? So just to give you a brief idea, these are some certificate, okay, and for every site there is a some valid certificate, so browser recognize that, and so that certificate has to be valid, okay, otherwise your browser will say that will obstruct the normal flow of the site, okay. And in some cases you even may not be able to load the site, right? So let's say your team is developing a website and you have created some site internally, you haven't published, okay, so initially you don't have any certificate issued from the developer side, okay. So generally we have seen that you get a certificate error, okay, so we'll see how to handle that, all those things, okay. So see this is the hope you understand this diagram, right? There are different layer, network layer, application layer, transport layer, internet layer, and then a network layer, right? We will not go deep into this particular topic, but this is a good website if you want to go into the deep for HTTP, HTTPS, SSL, TLS, what are those? You can go from through this site or any other site, right? So let's go to the code. We will see at the code level, okay. For this for the demo purpose, I don't have any website, okay, with me on which I can show you the exact how means I don't have any development site right now, otherwise I would have been would have been better, okay, but but I will show you how to write the code, okay. So this is the in the before setup. You have mentioned that Rest Assured dot use relaxed HTTPS validation. Okay, so whenever you are using this, if your site, let's say abc.com or whatever, dev.abc.com is throwing some certificate error, okay, some SSL certificate is not genuine or your browser is not recognizing, in those cases you will get this particular exception, SSL peer unverified exception, okay. This exception thrown when your SSL certificate are not valid or has been expired or any other case, right? So how to handle this particular exception? So the best way to handle this particular exception is you can write in your before class use relaxed HTTPS validation, okay. So let's see what is that. So what they have written is use relaxed HTTPS validation with protocol SSL, okay. So this means that you will trust all the hosts regardless if the SSL certificate is invalid, okay. So it will bypass all the check regarding SSL certificate, okay. And you can also write like this, restassured.config is equal to restassured config, SSL config, SSL config, relaxed HTTP validation. Okay, we have seen in the previous chapters that we can define a configuration and you can use that particular configuration all over the your test cases. But this is also good. You can simply write that in this way. Okay, so let's go come to the test case. So let's say this is your test case, okay, test SSL 1, okay. So see, in normal case we have write we generally write our test case like this, okay, given dot get www whatever abc.com whatever, then status code is 200, right? So if this is a development URL, let's say suppose that this is in, so if you run this particular case you will get SSL peer unverified exception, okay. I'm writing here. So you will get this particular exception, okay, but right now it won't come because this is a normal global URL, so you won't, we won't get this particular exception in demo, but in your test environment you will get such kind of exceptions. So to handle that, we will write, we have already relaxed the HTTPS, we have already bypassed the HTTPS validation here. So right now you can directly write given dot get dot abc then status code. This statement will work, okay? But if you don't want to write here, let's say I'm commenting this, so you can write here also given relax HTTPS validation when get whatever the your URL then status code is 200. Okay, so this way also you can use. So let me show you. I'm running using the test ng. Okay, so this case will get passed. Okay, and if you want to use before class, you can use in this way. You can, we have directly mentioned in the setup, and you can directly use given dot get your URL then status code. This will also work. Okay, so it's up to you how you want to use it. Okay, so this particular case will get passed. Fine. Okay, let's go to the next topic. That is TLS. So this is a, we are talking about the SSL, okay? But we are, in some cases we are also using the TLS certificate, okay? So nowadays TLS is getting used more than the SSL, or in combination of different things, HTTPS, TLS, all this thing, they are being used in combination, okay? So see, this is a bit different what we are using. So let me comment this, because we are already writing this particular relaxed, we are relaxing HTTPS validation here at the test level, so we don't need to do at the before class level, okay? So you can also pass the parameter here, okay? So this particular method is accepting the parameter also, like string protocol, like see here, string and the protocol, right? And this is the same thing. Same definition is given here. Just see the protocol. Protocol, the standard name of the request protocol. See the SSL context, etc. If you click on this particular link, this is the link. See, the all these are the string parameter you can pass. So right now we are passing the TLS this particular, but you can also pass SSL version 2, version 3, TLS version 1, 1.1, 1.2. Okay, so this is a nice document. You can go through this if you want to. You will get a lot of information from this particular document, okay? But on a higher level, so we can pass the particular whatever certificate or whatever protocol you are using in your company, in your case, and you can simply pass here. That's it. And let me run this particular case. So, right. So this test case has been passed. So fine, friends. I hope this topic is clear to you. I'm sorry I don't have any demo URL. Otherwise, it would have been a better session. But I hope if you need this particular chapter, means you must have some demo URL with you in your development with your development team. So just go and try with this particular method, and hope everything will be work as expected. Otherwise, just let me know, right? Okay, thank you, friends. Thanks for watching this particular chapter. And in the next chapter, we will see about the serialization and deserialization in Rest Assured. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.